It's something 85-year-old Dr. Helena Hicks will never forget.
We were just determined they weren't going to put us out based on nothing, just because we were black.
It happened inside this building at Howard and Lexington Streets in January 1955. This was a Reed's drugstore then. Hicks was a college senior at Morgan. She and six others have been waiting to catch a bus to school. Several passed by, but they were full. Hicks says she innocently suggested going inside where it was warm.
And they wouldn't serve us. They just kept telling us we had to leave. We didn't belong in there. And we decided we weren't going to leave.
She says they sat at the counter, tried to order hot tea, and were ignored.
There was no ugly exchange, no calling names. Well, they did, but we didn't. We were not something to throw away. That, you know, we were as good as anybody else, as worthy as anybody else. So we had no problem sticking to our guns.
About 30 minutes into the standoff, police came.
The police were baffled. They did not want to lock us up. And they weren't used to locking up college kids anyway. And they didn't know what to do. We weren't doing anything wrong. What they did was keep calling more policemen. So here are all these police cars and seven students, five of whom were female. They just weren't just trying to get to school, just trying to get warm till they got a bus to take them to school.
Dr. Hicks says she and the other students left when another bus arrived. Hers was the first sit-in during the civil rights movement. 2 days later, the drugstore became integrated. But the students' action eventually ignited a wave of sit-ins at lunch counters across the country.
I didn't even know. That hadn't invented that word, sit-in. That came along later.
Today, the building that once housed Reed's is for sale.
One interested buyer wants to turn it into a concert hall.
Dr. Hicks hopes whoever the new owner is, they preserve the counter and stools somewhere on site, if they still exist, as an historic symbol of the civil rights movement. In downtown, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.
And in case you're wondering, before they were called sit-ins, Dr. Hicks says the civil rights protests were called sit-downs. The students at Morgan State are reminded of that historic era. Inside the Student Union building, this display includes original stools from another Reed's drugstore. They're part of an exhibit paying homage to Morgan's civil rights pioneers from 1947 through 1963. The stools represent two things, a source of income for the business.
And they also represented a symbol of protest where the students would come in and sit and occupy this, take up space from a paying customer because they wouldn't be served.
Morgan's Dr. Simone Barrett says students learned they had economic power. They could be heard if they came peacefully in a group and there was safety in numbers.